So I literally like just finished writing this earlier today, so I do not have it memorized in the least. Mm-hmm. So, you know, be easy on me. All right. Halloween is among the oldest traditions in the world, as it touches on an essential element of the human condition, the relationship between the living and the dead. Every recorded civilization has created some form of ritual observance focused on what happens to people when they die, where they go, and how the living should best honor those who have passed. Countries around the world today celebrate a holiday similar to Halloween in one form or another, from Mexico's Day of the Dead to China's Tomb Sweeping Day. The origins of the modern Halloween start over 2,000 years ago with a group of people called the Celts. They lived about 2,000 to 3,000 years ago, mostly in the area that is now known as Ireland, the United Kingdom, and northern France. They celebrated their new year on November 1st in a celebration called Samhain. No, not that one. This one, which is actually pronounced Samhain and means summer's end. This day marked the end of the summer and the harvest and the beginning of the dark and cold winter. They believe that on the night before the new year dawned, the boundary between the worlds of the living and the dead became blurred. For a single night, the veil lifted and the spirits of the dead returned to walk the earth. Departed loved ones were expected and welcome to walk among them and interact with them. They would set out the favorite foods of the dead that had not moved on yet. However, deceased loved ones were not the only spirits expected to make an appearance on this night. Many other kinds of spirits, some of which had never had human form, could also appear. Elves, fairies, sprites, and dark energies were just as likely to pay a visit as the apparition of a loved family member. The Celts believed that these spirits could be troublemakers, causing problems and damaging crops. The food left out would not only be for lost loved ones, but also duplicate the less than friendly spirits. However, they also believed that the presence of spirits made it easier for the druids, or Celtic priests, to predict the future. For a people facing a long, dark, cold and unforgiving winter, these prophecies could be a great source of comfort. To commemorate the event, druids build huge sacred bonfires where the people gathered to burn crops and animals as sacrifices to the Celtic deities. During these celebrations, people would wear costumes, typically consisting of animal heads and skins, making themselves look monstrous so that fairies wouldn't be tempted to kidnap them. Other traditions of the festival included stocking up on supplies for the winter, slaughtering cattle, and disposing of the bones in bonfires, which in time came to be known as bonfires. Tragically, many of the traditions of Samhain have been lost to time and the Catholic Church attempting to erase and Christianize the holiday. By 43 AD, the Roman Empire had conquered the majority of Celtic territory. The Catholic Church slowly attempted to incorporate the pagan traditions into Christianity. On May 13, 609 AD, Pope Boniface IV dedicated the Pantheon in Rome in honor of all Christian martyrs, and the Catholic Feast of All Martyrs' Day was established in the Western Church. In the 8th century, Pope Gregory III expanded the festival to include All Saints and changed the name to All Saints' Day. He moved the observation from May 13th to November 1st. All Souls' Day would follow on November 2nd in 1000 AD to honor all of the dead. All Souls' Day was celebrated similarly to Samhain, with big bonfires, parades, and dressing up in costumes as saints, angels, and devils. The All Saints' Day celebration was called All Hallows or All Hallmas, from the English All Hallmas, meaning All Saints' Day. The night before it, the traditional night of Samhain in the Celtic religion, began to be called All Hallows' Eve and eventually Halloween. Despite the attempts of the church to replace the Celtic traditions with a church-sanctioned holiday, neither new holidays did away with the pagan aspects of the celebration. All Hallows' Eve continued much of the traditional pagan practices from before. However, it did change the holiday some. Previously, the Samhain festival was associated with all those who had gone before, with the earth, the change of the year, and this transformation was marked by celebration and communal activities. Once the festival was Christianized, All Hallows' Eve became a night of vigil, prayer, and fasting in preparation for the next day when the saints were honored at a far tamer celebration. The celebration of Halloween in America was extremely limited in colonial New England because of the rigid Protestant belief systems there. Halloween was much more common in Maryland and the southern colonies. As the beliefs and customs of different European ethnic groups and the American Indians meshed, a distinctly American version of Halloween began to emerge. The first celebrations included play parties, which were public events held to celebrate the harvest. Neighbors would share stories of the dead, tell each other's fortunes, dance, and sing. Colonial Halloween festivities also featured the telling of ghost stories and mischief-making of all kinds. By the middle of the 19th century, annual autumn festivities were common, but Halloween was not yet celebrated everywhere in the country. In the second half of the 19th century, Irish immigrants brought their traditions to America, and they helped to popularize the celebration of Halloween nationally. Over time, the holiday slowly began to lose its superstitious and religious aspects. In the late 1800s, there was a move in America to mold Halloween into a holiday more about community and neighborly get-togethers, and less about ghosts, pranks, and witchcraft. Parents were encouraged by newspapers and community leaders to take anything frightening or grotesque out of Halloween celebrations. By the beginning of the 20th century, Halloween had mostly lost its superstitious overtones and was largely a family-friendly event. Halloween traditions, starting off with the jack-o'-lantern. Jack-o'-lanterns originate from the celebration of Samhain. Carved turnips hung in windows or doors or attached by string to sticks were embedded with coals and used to scare off wandering evil spirits. Later Irish tradition switched to pumpkins when they came to America as they were easier to carve up. The name jack-o'-lantern comes from an Irish myth. The story goes that a man named Jack invited the devil to have a drink with him. Always a great idea. The man was nicknamed Stingy Jack, and he didn't want to pay for his drink. He convinced the devil to turn himself into a coin so that Jack could pay for their drinks. However, once he did so, Jack put the coin in his pocket next to a silver cross, preventing the devil from changing back. Jack eventually freed him under the condition that the devil wouldn't bother Jack for 1 year and, should Jack die, the devil wouldn't claim his soul. The next year, Jack tricked the devil into climbing into a tree to pick a piece of fruit. While he was in this tree, Jack carved a cross into the tree so that the devil wouldn't be able to come back down. Jack released him only when the devil promised not to bother Jack for 10 more years. However, soon after, Jack died. God wouldn't allow such an unworthy figure to come into heaven, but the devil couldn't claim his soul. Instead, the devil sent Jack off into the night with only a burning coal to light his way. Jack put the coal into a carved-out turnip and has been roaming the earth ever since. The Irish referred to this ghostly figure as Jack of the Lantern, which eventually turned into Jack-o'-lantern. The early origins of trick-or-treating come from later traditions of Samhain. People would dress as ghosts, demons, and other malevolent creatures, performing antics in exchange for food and drink in a custom known as mime. Fast forward a few centuries, and during All Souls' Day, poor people would visit the houses of wealthier families and receive pastries called soul cakes in exchange for a promise to pray for the souls of the homeowner's dead relatives. The distribution of whole soul cakes was encouraged by the church as a way to replace the ancient practice of leaving food and wine out for roaming spirits. Known as souling, the practice was later taken up by children who would go from door to door asking for gifts such as food, money, and ale. In Scotland and Ireland, young people took part in a tradition called guising, dressing up in costumes and accepting offerings from various households. Rather than pledging to pray for the dead, they would sing a song, recite a poem, tell a joke, or perform some other sort of trick before collecting their treat, which typically consisted of fruit, nuts, or coins. In the early 20th century, Irish and Scottish communities revived the old world traditions of souling and guising in the United States. By the 1920s, however, pranks had become the Halloween activity of choice for rowdy adolescents. The Great Depression exacerbated the problem, with Halloween mischief often devolving into vandalism, physical assaults, and sporadic acts of violence. Despite the best efforts of many schools and communities, vandalism continued to plague celebrations in many of the communities during this time. Somewhere around this time, the practice of trick-or-treating was revived in an attempt to curtail some of the delinquent behavior. The efforts were delayed by the start of World War II and sugar rationing. However, during the post-war baby boom and the end of sugar rationing, candy companies capitalized on the new lucrative tradition, launching national advertising campaigns specifically aimed at Halloween. By the 1950s, town leaders had successfully limited vandalism, and Halloween had evolved into a holiday dedicated mainly at the young. Trick-or-treating was a relatively inexpensive way for an entire community to be able to share in the Halloween tradition. In theory, families could also prevent tricks from being played on them by providing neighborhood children with small treats. Thus, a new American tradition was born, and it has continued to grow. Today, Americans spend an estimated $6 billion annually on Halloween, making it the country's second largest commercial holiday after Christmas. Though Samhain is an ancient tradition, many neo-pagans and Wiccans in the modern day continue to observe the holiday as closely as possible to how it was in the ancient past. The central theme of Samhain was transformation. The year turned from the light days to the dark ones. The new year started. The dead crossed over into the land of the living or moved on to the other side. People disguised themselves as entities, and entities could appear as people. Animals were slaughtered and turned into food, while grains, fruits, and vegetables were similarly transformed for winter storage, and wood and bone went up in the flames of bonfires as smoke. Today, those same themes of transformation can be found. Some of the most popular Halloween costumes are werewolves, a human turning into a wolf, vampires, a man transforming into a bat, and ghosts, a person dying and turning into a spirit. Many different costumes represent the universal fear of death and the unknown, which, for a night, is overcome. People become that which they would normally dread, and in this transformation, neutralize the fear. Every year, there is a new series of scary and horror movies for people to enjoy, and many people love watching and rewatching classics like Halloween or Nightmare on Elm Street. People everywhere set up haunted houses and scary attractions for people to peruse and enjoy. Aspects of fear and horror are normalized. People roam the streets uninhibited, brushing elbows with goblins, ghouls, and witches, and receiving candy from strangers without a second thought. It is a time of community, of coming together, of celebration, and of sugar comas. At its most basic level, Halloween is a triumph of hope over fear, which is what it meant to the ancient Celts at Samhain thousands of years ago.
Thanks. But I must admit, this was really a great presentation, Maya.
Oh, I forgot. Here are my sources.